which you would imagine would suit the Sri Lankans perhaps a little better than England. Sri Lanka have won the toss and have decided to field first. A formula that worked extremely well for them. Only had one win against England in one day internationals, and that came in a World Cup all the way back in 2013. Maya Boucher once again gets the chance to open the batting. Nicked and gone, straight to that slip. Kula Saria pitching the ball up, getting it to swing, and that is a huge wicket for Sri Lanka.
Taking a simple catch in slip, and Tammy Beaumont just advancing and looking to go into the leg side against the swing. It's really nice delivery.
Oh, that's been smoked. That should go all the way. Long levers from Maya Boucher. That came right out of the middle of the bat.
Punch. It's gone a long way over the boundary. That's a really good pickup. Great connection.
That's a sweet shot. Yeah, needed stopping. Needed the dive to come off. And that's high class from Capsie. Oh, and gone. What a beauty from Prabhadani.
Lines and lengths that Sri Lanka have bowled. Alice Capsie just going back to a foolish delivery. Just nips off the seam. Sri Lanka get their reward for toiling away.
Boucher just keeps the blade open long enough to feed it between extra cover and mid-off.
Over the infield.
Which Maya Boucher does. Doesn't get all of it, but it skids off the advertising mat and brings up another boundary.
Oh, nicely timed. So strong off the back foot. That Sciver-Brunt doesn't need a huge amount of length to climb into it.
Look how she uses the depth of that crease as well. Plays it right under the eye line. Doesn't try and overhit it. She's just trying to pick the gap. Well, she does. With it.
Well, again, nicely timed. Manages to split the two out in the deep. So Nat Sciver-Brunt really getting into her work now. Well, that's the best of them all. We've seen a couple off the back foot from that Sciver-Brunt. This time she's saying, I'm going downtown.
Again, we saw the depth of the crease used. This time it's the shuffle, and that is flush. Right out of the middle from Sciver-Brunt. And this one, I really like this. She's giving the spinners something to think about here. Sri Lanka spinners have been pretty dominant over the course of this.
And again, she's managed to work it through with ease. Nat Sciver-Brunt really is. And again, has she managed to find the gap? Yes, she has. Nat Sciver-Brunt. That's a freebie. Maya Boucher deals with it nicely. Just helps the ball on its way. Well, that came right out of the screws. Maya Boucher making the most of that free hit, and again goes all the way. Her second six of the day. Though is that an England A side are also going out there again. Nicely timed by Nat Sciver-Brunt. We've seen a few of those today.
That gap at mid-wicket is being, well, it needs a little bit more help on the leg side, but that is a wonderful innings, a half century 51 from just 38 deliveries in testing conditions with the ball moving around.
Well, it's a splendid innings by a fantastic cricketer. Nat Sciver-Brunt has broken the record for England's fastest ODI 100.
She's going to do neither.
Yeah, she's been magnificent, Daggers.
Belinda Clark. The other six.
Alan!
And shelled. And you just get that sense, Lauren Winfield Hill. Six overs upcoming.
Yeah, Alan! Another chance goes begging. He saw a cat.
Catch it!
Shouts a catch. Fallen short. Oh, there's been chances. That one was difficult. Coming quickly.
Falling short. The trajectory that Natsiver hit it.
Another opportunity, maybe. And finally, Sri Lanka managed to hold on to one. And it brings to a close what has been a superb display of power hitting. Hammered away from Amy Jones. It could be the end of it, and is. Second wicket for Dilhari.
Amy Jones just advancing down and just lost control of the bat face. Got a little slice. And it's a good catch.
Right across the line, that will go all the way from Bess Heath. And that's what she is capable of, what she has been brought into the side to do. Well run. Oh, I tell you what, this could be close, you know. I wonder if, because Alice Davidson Richards didn't slide her bat in. They're going to take a look at this.
Roll it through, ball is in the hand. Keep rolling. Freeze it there. The batter has not made their ground. I'm ready for my decision for the big screen.
Full toss, cross the line, could be her downfall, and is almost good enough from Bess Heath. Prabhadani interested. Charlie Dean just trying to work it around. Not quite sure if there was a little bit of bat on there, perhaps.
Original decision is not out. It's pitching outside leg. I'm ready to go back.
Relatively easy. And the correct decision from James Middlebrook.
Any sort of pressure. And on that, we've got a dot ball.
Anyway, last ball. And it won't be a dot. It'll be at least one. And maybe a run out. Should be a run out. Is a run out. Sarah Glenn selflessly sacrificing herself for the cause of trying to get an extra run.
Ooh, top edge flies over the head of Amy Jones and Nat Sivert. Keeper and slip respectively. Amy Jones thinks there's a tickle. Mahika Gore's running into a stiff breeze, so she might not have heard it if it was faint.
Yeah, roll it through for me. Keep rolling. It's a flat line. Keep rolling. I'm satisfied there's no bat. I'm ready to go back to Anna on field.
Anna Harris, quite right. With the naked eye. Or semi-naked. Slap down the ground. And that is a shot of authority from Sanjuani. She might be getting some around chest height. Oh my goodness, emphatic. A sight that every fast bowler loves to see, and that is stumps lying on the ground and bales flying.
It's full, it's fast from Lauren Filer. Just clips the pads, rattles into the stumps.
Gone. Superb bowling. Beautifully taken by Alice Davidson Richards at slip. That is high quality left arm swing bowling from Mahika Gore.
A lovely shape from Mahika Gore. It's full. the swings away. It's a good low catch from Alice Davison-Richards.
In the air, but through the gap. Yeah, angle was narrowed by Alice Capsey getting in tight, but the placement was perfect.
Straight through, Lauren Filer. She's been drawing in the outside edge. Now she's gone straighter. Perhaps the extra pace has beaten Delaney, and they have their third.
But it was the length delivery, and that's actually what has been so impressive about Filer. Yes, the pace is there. The accuracy and the length that she's been bowling in the last week or so has been eye-catching there. Targeting the stumps, top of the stumps as well.
Well, not much hanging around for Atapattu after not scoring a run for half an hour. Charlie Dean is in on the action. And Chamari Atapattu, perhaps reluctantly, is going to review it.
Copy. The ball is passing close to the bat. I'd like to confirm with Ultra Edge when ready. Yeah, original decision is out. Pitching in line. Impact is in line. I'm ready to go back to James on field.
James Middlebrook getting it right. And a lot going for it. So Chamari Atapattu on her way.
Oh, yeah. Chipped yeah. up and taken. Off her own bowling, very good, Charlie Dean. It's something that you've just been mentioning, Mark Butcher, that ability for overspin. Maybe the batter's thinking that they've made it to the pitch of the ball, but actually, they're about a foot short, gladly received.
Yeah, she's good, Charlie Dean. She really is. It's just wonderful to see a finger spinner get that much energy on the ball. Not looking just to fire it in and restrict scoring. Genuinely looking to take a wicket. Wraps that finger up and over the ball.
ICC events. Oh, another one. Another one. Little feather. Hassini Pereira. And this is the thing about Charlie Dean. She gets good players out.
Yeah, the heavier side spin this time. Pereira just finds her hands drawn towards the ball as it spins past.
That is absolute off-spinning perfection. Tossed it up, little drift away from the right-hander, turned back through the gate. Thanks very much. Three in the over for Dean.
It's Michael Vaughan about Sachin Tendulkar. Drop, little bit of drift, sharp turn. Batter again thinks they've got to the pitch a bit, but they're miles away.
Yeah! Played on. Charlie Dean in the action, in with another wicket and a 5-wicket haul for Charlie Dean. She has been outstanding.
Lovely shape and control. Just a little bit of turn. Bit of assistance for Charlie Dean from the batter. Played off.
Setting things up nicely for the spinners to come in. And clean up, and again, Sarah Glenn this time in on the action. Her first wicket of the evening. And it's the ninth down now for Sri Lanka.
Yeah, the ball is passing close to the bat. I'd like to confirm with Ultra Edge when ready. Original decision is out. It's pitching in line, impact is in line, and wickets are hitting. I'm ready to go back to Anna on field.
All right, decision. Straight through. Change of angle has done the trick for Lauren Filer. It's also done the trick for England as they complete this ODI series with a win.
Congratulations to
and they
England
do it convincingly. They win by 161 runs.